The former DA leader speaks about a new vehicle, reforms, criticizing the political landscape, calling for new coalitions to form in the political arena. Mr. Maimane, what do you know about this new vehicle? What does it entail? What is it?
Well, let's diagnose the problem so that when we talk about the solutions, it becomes easier to understand. Firstly, our politics are such that often, and it happens globally, you get big corporates who buy big politicians, who co-opt big unions, and they distribute pittance to the poor. And the model works like that. It articulates itself when people bring big campaign finances to big politicians. Those politicians are beholden to their agenda and to their parties. And the net effect of that means that ultimately we only interact with politicians when it comes time to vote. Whilst all of that is happening, epitomized even by how we feel as a country at the moment, that our government is perhaps distant from it. So I think we need to get back to saying, can citizens own their nation? Can citizens actually hold their politicians to account? So when we understand what a new vehicle must look like, it ought to get back to citizens. It ought to get back to ground and saying to people, I'll be accountable to you. That's why electoral reform is necessary. And perhaps we need to think harder about who votes for who. Secondly, we need to reform our economy. That's about not putting a concentration of power in a few entities, but really broadening economic opportunities so that more can participate. That requires deliberate reform. And we need to think about our society hard, about saying our society as it sits at the moment is a society upon which large input in the geographic spaces that are funding governments in. And further, families have been split up, where fathers were told, you will go work in a mine, and mothers were told, you can go work as a domestic worker elsewhere away from home. And the consequence of that is that many of our families in society are broken. So we need a reformation of society, of our economy, and of our politics. We need a movement that is led by people, for the people, that will challenge the status quo. And I think certainly my contribution to society is to be able to get back to that discussion. So that leadership in society isn't just political, but it also emerges from civil society, from NGOs, and more citizens can participate in our democracy. When you go to Parliament tomorrow and say, what is being discussed there, and will it matter to citizens? That must be inherent for how many young people want to in fact work in our country, and how do we ensure that those young people can hold their public representatives to account? We have had the same political infrastructure over and over again, delivering the same outcomes. Yes, are we just going to keep going when the numbers of unemployment just keep rising, when there's a distance between citizens and their political connected reps? It can't carry on like that. So a new political party might simply just be going, let's add another color to the many colors of political parties that exist. Actually, we need a new coalition, a new vehicle, something that will come back to the people, and it be inherently for them.
What is this new vehicle? Characterize it. Are you in discussions of forming this new vehicle? And what is it?
I have spent the last while, obviously, engaging different actors, different players in society. And at the right time, I think those particular individuals need to be able to articulate for themselves. My duty is to say what I know is that the system as we have it now doesn't work. How do we change it for the future? And so at the right time, we'll be able to communicate what that in fact will look like and how we can engage more society. I think more citizens must have a dialogue. And for starters, I think we must have a conversation in South Africa. The first question we should ask ourselves as citizens is, does our current formulation work?
Mr. Maimane, do you still see yourself in politics in a year's time to come?
Yeah, I love this country. I love the people of this country. I love the vision well articulated of a non-racial South Africa, an inclusive South Africa, a country of abundant opportunities and are given to all citizens. This is something I will give my life to. And so ultimately I've got to make sure that we are participants in it. I'm not going to surrender that role. I'm not going to surrender the role to even the current landscape. I'm certainly going to work with all citizens to make sure that we can achieve that. So I'll be around. And I think in many ways, we owe it to this beautiful country that we cannot sit back and allow things to happen and say we cannot do anything. I've always maintained, and evil does in fact triumph when good men do nothing. And I'm not suggesting any sense of goodness. I'm simply suggesting that more of us must participate in the political space because it matters to more citizens, and I'll certainly be contributing.
Will you be the leader of this new vehicle that you're talking about?
I will be a part of it. And I want more citizens to participate, and let's allow more people to be a part of the journey. And how it looks and how it formulates itself is a long-term project. And certainly, it must be able to set its own goals so that at its appropriate time, it can be a part of what happens in society. So society's voice must be heard. That's all I'm asking. And the voice of citizens must be at the forefront. Will it be part of the 2021 local government elections? Well, that's not the issue. The issue, as I started, is that the starting point for South Africa is we need an electoral reform. How do we ensure that the people we elect are accountable to people? And therefore, to achieve that, we have to change the statutes. So, election cycle after election cycle, we can keep perpetuating more of the same. We need to change the laws so that we can ultimately ensure that accountability is effective. Otherwise, we're going to perpetuate more of the same.
When is an announcement due on this new vehicle that you speak about and which particular actors that you have in mind?
I think the consultations will take place. They'll take place as long as long. We've got a deepest understanding and we've got a deepen the commitment. And simply, I think I want to give license to citizens who say they want to be a part of it to be able to engage in such.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman. Hope to be at your announcement of this new vehicle. And I wonder who's part of it.
My great honor, and I'll certainly look forward to engaging you in due course.